ITU Secretary General Dr. Hamdan Touri, Mr. Sami Bashir, Director of ITU Development, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the State of Qatar and ictQATAR, I would like to thank the Republic of India for their kind hospitality in hosting WTDC 2010. I would like also to thank the ITU and the organizers of this important event and for their hard work. I do believe that, and I would like to thank ITU, and I would like to thank Dr. Touri for all the great things that they've been doing to empower the forgotten people of this world. It was 4 years ago that the last WTDC meeting was held in my home country, Qatar. This was an important time for my country because we were at the beginning of our concerted efforts to proactively integrate ICT into the very fabric of our society. Qatar leadership at the very highest level recognized that ICT would be the catalyst to our nation's social and economic development, and that's why ictQATAR was founded 5 years ago. I must say that it was quite a journey, and I'd like to share some of our progress in that journey with you. The admirable and ambitious action plan that resulted from 2006 WTDC meeting in Doha served as a valuable platform for Qatar as we developed our nation ICT strategy that we hoped would allow our citizens to be active members of the global information society. We were able to learn from the experience of other member states, and based on their guidance and the Doha Declaration, Qatar focused its effort into four broad areas: creating a legal and institutional environment, enabling an attractive market environment, building an advanced ICT infrastructure, and establishing a good skills and a human resource-based environment. Collectively, these four pillars create the condition to build an information society, to provide opportunities to socially and economically enrich society, and to promote true global citizenship. I will share with you in very brief detail our progress in each of the four pillars. We viewed the creation of a legal and institutional environment that supports private sector participation, investment, and competition as a cornerstone for sector development and creating a new business opportunities. We recognize the need to engage our various stakeholders at the earliest stage of our development plans as they reflected the shared interest of both public and private entities. We adopted policies and regulations that are designed to increase investment in the sector and encourage the introduction of leading-edge technologies. We have worked to review and remove onerous practices to better enable an efficient environment. We embrace the importance of openness and transparency for an effective legal environment. When it comes to the enabling and attractive market environment, we have also worked in this pillar. This pillar will foster a sustainable and diversified economy. Given the size of our market, our approach to opening up the telecom sector has been through managed liberalization. This was done to attract serious and experienced investors to deploy mobile and fixed network and to establish bases for effective and sustainable competition. We adopted technology-neutral approach to the sector to enable universal and ubiquitous access to telephony. And an attractive market environment is not only about supply, but of course also demand. Demand attracts investment, spurs entrepreneurs, and promotes creativity and innovation, such as the development of relevant content. Creating demand is also critical to the support of large-scale investment, such as next-generation broadband that we are doing. Qatar, also, we are building an advanced ICT infrastructure that will allow used to take advantage of next generation solution and opportunities. We have now 63% of the whole, the households, they are connected to a broadband, but we are studying the best approach for high-speed NGN coverage. We recognize that a one-size-fits-all solution might not be practical, so we are developing a pragmatic strategy that can utilize the best infrastructure possible by government investing directly and in partnership with the private sector. We are also working with international operators and other investors to expand our international gateway capacity. The fourth dimension, which may be the most important, is building a good resource-based environment. This means people and helping enable people to advance their skills and be better able to take full advantages of the benefit of ICT in their daily life, both professionally and personally. People need to be digitally literate. This means that they need to have the essential understanding about ICT, how can ICT benefit their life, and how they will be able to be an active participants in the knowledge society. We are having a number of leading programs to address this very need. As you can see, Qatar is striving to create a positive environment for ICT growth and adoption, and we are committed to embed it into our society to help us achieve our national ambitions and help our citizens thrive in the global market. I wish you all the very best during this conference and look forward to sharing ideas and experience with you as we work towards our shared vision of realizing the benefit of ICT to develop a global society for all. Thank you.